welcome back to my blog. And for those of you who haven't been here before, welcome. I just wanted to first off say thank you again so much. I'm so blessed to have all of you supporting me. We've raised $850, and that's incredible, and I can't believe it. We're almost there. Within 2 weeks, I'll be leaving to go abroad. I'm speechless. I have no words. I really do appreciate all the support you've given me, and I'm just excited to really get this campaign off the ground. So basically, I just wanted to start this video and talk about why the Alzheimer's Association is so important to me. Over the past couple weeks, I've had people ask how the Alzheimer's Association really ties in with me studying abroad. In my first video, I spoke to you all about how 1 in 3 seniors dies with Alzheimer's. That means that out of the 300,000 US students that study abroad each year, 100,000 of them will be diagnosed with Alzheimer's. That's a crazy number, 1 in 3, to think that anyone can really be diagnosed with Alzheimer's and really forget the life that they lived previously. Basically, all of my college career, I went through watching my grandfather suffer from Alzheimer's, and it's a tough disease to watch somebody live with. He went from being a man that was hardworking and really, you know, active and self-sufficient to kind of being bedridden by the end, and it's tough. It is, and I feel for everyone who has to watch a loved one go through this, because not only are you sitting there watching somebody you love become somebody that you don't know, you're also sitting there thinking, this could be me. It's not something that you want to think. It's not something that anybody should want to live through or have to live through, because it's just awful. And I found a quote online, and it really kind of put things into perspective. It said that aging isn't graceful. Nobody ages in a graceful way, but nobody should have to go through Alzheimer's. That makes it 10 times, 20 times worse. You know, it's interesting how you go from being an infant, you become self-sufficient. Once you hit your teens, you move out in your 20s, and then when you age, you basically become an infant yet again. You go back to wearing diapers, you rely on somebody to feed you, take care of you, bathe you. And it's weird that the circle of life works like that. It's just something that hits home so hard, because you sit there and you fear that this is how you're gonna become. Because it is hereditary, most of the times. So you sit there and wonder, and you're like, is this gonna be me? Is this how my life is gonna end? That's a question that I've dealt with for quite a while now. I would say a couple years. And, you know, I look at my grandfather, and the older generation doesn't have that information to say, oh, I need to, you know, strengthen my brain, strengthen myself so that I can prevent this. And now we're starting to have that information, and we're starting to understand that we need to keep our minds active and keep active. This is where studying abroad comes in. And you should be traveling, you should be doing anything you possibly can to keep your mind active. Me studying abroad, traveling is something I love to do, and to be able to experience 10 countries for 4 months is incredible. I just booked a trip to Munich, Germany, a trip to Interlaken, Switzerland, and I can't believe that I get this experience, and I want to be able to remember those experiences when I'm older, and I want to be able to look back and say that, yeah, I had this amazing experience. I got to study abroad with all of my friends and really enjoy life. And that's what everybody should be doing. That's what I want to inspire people to do. I want to inspire people to travel and to live their life to its fullest. Because you never know when one day you're going to turn around and things will be totally different and you won't be able to do what you love anymore. So that's what Traveling Purple is really about. It's about making memories so other people can can have memories. I hope it clears things up a little bit as to what this campaign is really about. Once again, thanks so much. Look out for some new videos coming up. I leave in 2 weeks? No. I leave in 3 weeks, so I can't wait to finally make my first video over abroad and share it all with you and hopefully give you ideas if you want to travel. I'll definitely be putting out videos talking about my experiences and what if you go to Florence or any other country that I visit. Hopefully it'll give you ideas as to places that you should travel, places I loved, places you could maybe avoid. So thank you all for watching, and can't wait to hear from you, and let's keep raising some money for such a great cause. Thanks, guys.